Thank you so much for coming along. I really appreciate it, especially as it's so hot, you could be in rather nice pims, but you're here with us, and we really, really appreciate that. Thank you so much. We're Voce, good to see you. Hopefully, I see some faces that were here at our first concert in January, so thank you so much for coming along again. Also, welcome if this is the first time you've seen us. Just a couple things I want to say to get started. The last concert we did was quite a varied programme. We had some classical pieces, some pop music, and some madrigals, really, really varied. And that, the idea of that was a little snapshot of what our vision for Voce was. Today is a little bit of that. It's a little bit more on the classical side because of the theme of today. We're obviously in this amazing building where the Somerset Registration Service is now. So it's a little bit more, slightly more formal, I'd say, a little bit more on the classical side today, but we've got a little bit of Stevie Wonder in there and a little bit of a mixture too. So hopefully there'll be something for everyone tonight. I'd also like just to say thank you to representatives from the Taunton and Parish Precept, because we've recently been awarded a grant, so we really appreciate that. That will really help us in our ambitions as a choir. So thank you to those of you who have done that too. You just heard Northern Lights. The composer described the text of this as, it's about the Northern Lights, and it's about the love and the powerful beauty, he called it, the terrible beauty of the Northern Lights. And the theme of today is about birth and death. So that, birth, death and marriage, that's kind of one of the nice ones, isn't it? Birth, death and marriage. So that one's a little bit of birth and death, just to kick us off. The next song is a pop song arranged by our very own Sue Briggs. And this is called Wires by a band called Athletes. And it's about, the lead singer wrote this about his son who almost died in intensive care as an infant, but then pulled through and is now thriving. After that, you'll hear Seal Lullaby, which has been described as a perfect description of the intimacy between a parent and a child. Hope you enjoy Wires and Seal Lullaby. two beautiful pieces, and very, very different as well, I think. The next piece is another arranger. We really feel like Voce is a fantastic vessel for composers and arrangers within our own ranks, as well as local composers and arrangers, to have a vessel to perform their music. And this next one is another arrangement by very, very Richard Burkwart. This is a song by Leonard Cohen. And Leonard Cohen, the song is in the style of a Greek dance, so it's by style, which we'll hear plenty of. Getting faster, gradually faster, kind of thing. You might have seen people dancing around like this, smashing some plates, that sort of vibe. And it's about love and death. So this goes into the marriage and death categories for me. The feel of it, at first listen, is almost like a love song, dancing to the end of love. But Leonard Cohen wrote this about the concentration camps and the Jews in the camps playing classical music whilst their, you know, brothers and sisters and family and friends were brutally killed. So it's really, really powerful through that lens. After that, we'll be moving on to Set Me as a Seal. I'll talk about that a little more in a minute. This is Dancing to the End of Life.
Thank you.
Similar time to the piece we just heard, and it uses a similar text as well. Some of it is different, but a lot of it is taken from the Song of Solomon. So I just thought it was interesting to put those next to each other to see how different composers dealt with it. The text that sticks out for me is the many waters cannot quench love, neither can the floods drown. And I just think that's really, really powerful and quite dark imagery as well, to be honest, being drowned in. Love overcoming that huge strength. So this is Greater Love Hath No Man Need Us.
Mm.
so much. That brings us almost to the end of the half. At half time, there'll be some drinks available just out in the foyer, so please do dig into a nice refreshing glass of wine or something softer. And after that, we'll just only be about 10-15 minute interval, and we'll be back in here for the second half. Before we do that, though, I'd like to hand over to Amber to talk a little bit about Richard Mico.
I work for Municipal. This is where I work. And not long ago, Sarah, who's somewhere in the audience, who is one of our serving officers, pointed out that it was the 500th anniversary of this building being incorporated into the town. It was a grammar school 500 years ago, and it's gone through lots of iterations. And you can actually see on the windows the sort of carvings and stone symbols of art over the centuries into the building. I was tasked with doing something to celebrate the anniversary, so here we are. And it's pointed out there's a composer called Richard Mico, who was born in Taunton, and his family are buried in St James Parish Church. And he studied here and then went on to be a musician, a court musician for the wife of Charles I. So I found some piece of music. He only wrote for the viola da gamba, my any choral music. So I'm not sure if I can do it myself. I saw some contemporary poets around the same time as him. Richard Ayler, who's one of the songs later, he caused all sorts of hoo-ha with religious situations. He was one of the leaders of the Civil War. You know? And Thomas Ford was a lutenist and a composer poet for the court of the king at the same time that Mico was the court of the queen. Their history doesn't record whether they were friends, whether they would have appreciated having their music at Smart centuries later. I've taken Ford's song, and I think it's just an infinite
Thanks so much.
Thank you. Thank you.
the same set by Josef Reinberger. We sang Abendlied in our last concert, and I think we just really enjoyed it as a choir, so we thought we'd look at another one of his pieces from the same set. And Morgenlied, morning song, Abendlied is evening song, so you know, we have to shoehorn that into the theme, of course. Morgenlied, birth of a new day, Abendlied, death of a new day. So I hope you enjoyed Morgenlied and Abendlied.
Thank you.
Harry, and it's just a celebration of kind of all three of the themes, of birth, of a new birth, in heaven in this case, of the marriage of the church and of people of the church and God, and death, which obviously takes us to that new birth in heaven. So this is it's a huge, huge thing, and I think a really great way to send us out into the summer evening. Thank you so much for coming. Also, just a super big thanks as well to every member of the choir for their hard work, to David and Tash for accompanying page turning, to Amber for presenting these lovely programmes as well, and to the committee that made it all worthwhile. Just give them a round. Thank you. But, you know, what should I do? I'll read you some of the lyrics. Prop your ears if you are sensitive. Fair Phyllis I saw sitting all alone, feeding her flock near to the mountainside. The shepherds knew not whither she was gone, but after her lover, Amyntas, hide, they end up, she ends up finding them up and down they wander, and then they find each other, and then up and down they wander. This is Fair Phyllis. Thanks so much.